Hi, I'm Cindy Gunter-Baldo, and welcome to another edition of Llamas Love Lettering. If you haven't noticed, my camera's at kind of an odd angle today. I want to see if it is a little easier for you to see how I'm lettering by doing it at this weird angle. But if you're getting seasick or you just think it looks stupid, let me know. This is all new to me. Anyway, firstly, I'd like to make a couple of apologies. For one, I'm sorry this video took longer than usual to get released. I've been busy. And I remind myself that doing YouTube videos is not, I'm not like beholden to it, but I like making these and it's been a hell of a weekend and so I just haven't had the chance to sit down and do it. Secondly, I'm so sorry that last video, I forgot Q and R in my rush to get done. I forgot to do Q and R. So I'm going to start it out today by showing you Q and R with the serif font that we worked on in the last video. Sorry. And then I guess my third apology to you is that if my voice is kind of hoarse or if it goes out, I was at a wedding last night and there was a lot of Journey played and I sang along with it because who wouldn't? So I'm sore and cranky and hungover slightly and my voice hurts. So, but I'm doing this, damn it. It's been long enough. Anyway, so this week we're going to work on this kind of font. It's very similar to the serif font that we worked on before, except this is a sans serif font. So you can tell I went to the wedding. Look at my pretty nails. I never do that. So this is the same kind of font. It's just instead of with the serif on it, it's sans serif. Now, if you don't know what the difference between serif and sans serif is, I can't remember if we talked about it or not. We probably did, but hungover. This little like that. That's a serif. You see how there's not one of those? On this, like, this is a sans serif letter. You add the serifs on, and now it's a serif letter. Get it? Anyway, so instead of doing the lined worksheets, because if I was going to be doing those this week, I swear to God, it would never have gotten done, because I am just that tired. I just decided to do a sheet of the alphabet the way I do it to give you something to practice on. And we're going to kind of do what we did last week and just work on graph paper. Again, this is kind of taking your own printing and fancying it up a little bit. It's pretty self-explanatory, but I'm going to just write through each letter so you can see how I do it to give you kind of the idea. One of the things you'll notice, and I can kind of zoom in here. Let me see if I can do this without knocking the camera over. Zoom. Notice. I didn't fill the letters in all the way. I like that scribbly look. Let me see if I can zoom back out. Zoom back out. Woohoo! Back to normal. I didn't fill them in all the way because I'm lazy, for one. And for two, I like the scribbly look. You get a little bit more, kind of room to screw up if you do the scribbly. Like, you can get away with more mistakes if you do the scribbly rather than having everything look perfect. So, I like to go with that one. But you can fill it in yourself solid if you want to. Anyway, so I'm just going to get a piece of graph paper. And I'm going to work on this. Same way that I did the worksheet itself. And we're going to start before I get into that sans serif. I'm going to start with the Q and the R with the serif, okay? Actually, the Q and the R with the sans serif, and the Q, at least, with the sans serif and the serif kind of look similar to each other, but I do it kind of like this. Do the O, make the O face, like I said. When you get it back up to the top, you keep going. You just make kind of an oval on the inside. That's the way I do all of my O's in this style. Right? And then I just add a little tail with a little bubbly thing. And that's how I do uppercase Q with that serif styled font. For the lowercase Q, you kind of you draw your Q and then you do your inside part of the Q. And then you add your serif and bring it down. And that's how I do lowercase q. I make it as easy as possible. I don't add a whole bunch of bells and whistles to it because q's are a pain in the ass and you don't have to do them very often. So you might as well not make it too hard on yourself. And for r's, now here's the thing. You can do this a couple of different ways where you don't want to fuck yourself up. Now you can, you do it this way. And then just add the serif, and you can go inside and add the bottom, and then add here, and then color it in because of that little fucker that's right there, right? Or eventually you'll get better where you're not going to have to worry about that. And I usually just thicken this guy up a little bit to make it look kind of nice. Or you can make your R, add your like little thingy, add the serif and pull it out extra. And then add the end on like that. It's crooked, but whatever. That's one way to do it without getting that little bastard right there. Sooner or later, you're going to get used to it, and then you're going to be able to go like this. Just take your serif and leave yourself enough space. That just requires the muscle memory to know when to stop. Anyway, for the lowercase r, it's pretty simple. You draw your line, you add your serif, and then go in like that. And then you just add the rest. See? Anyway, so there we go. The sad, sad letters that got misplaced this last time. So let's move on and see if I can manage to do this without forgetting any letters. Okay. So for A, now this is because I'm filling them in with scribblies and I'm not trying to make them negative space. It's okay if you get those little bastards, the little lines that go inside. It's fine. Sooner or later, your muscle memory will kick in with this as well, and you won't have to worry about those. But for now, let's just do it kind of more colored in. So for A, you make your A. Now, the way most of these letters work, at least in my mind, is you make your letter. Remember to leave a little extra space because you're going to be fattening. Then pick a side and go with that side and add like a thickening. And then just kind of scribble it full. And there's your A. Lowercase a. Make it kind of bubbly and big. You draw your A. Same side. You just bring it down. It's really simple, but it looks really cool. Especially, I used it in my planner this week. I'll show you in, when I'm done with all of this. B. Remember to make it a little extra. A little extra bubbly. Drop it down. And that's the little bastard I'm talking about. Give it a scribble. Now you'll notice, unlike with the serif font, I'm not doing both sides. If I was doing it like the serif font, I would fill it in here like this. And you can do that too. I'm just choosing not to because I kind of like this one side dealy. But you can do either. You can experiment with it however you want to. It's your writing and your planner. See? Just kind of drop it down. Drop it like it's hot. See why I love the scribbling? Very little effort, but it looks stylized. It's one of my favorite things in art is when you find something that is easy, but looks like you spent time on it. It's the great, like, the great magician's tricks of the art world. I worked with someone once at the D, same deal. I worked with someone once who was able to draw a bowl of cereal using just negative space. She would just color in the shadows, color in, and you'd watch her do it. See how you did the D there? You just leave it. Again, if you wanted to do both sides, you could go like that. That's not what I'm trying to do, though. The D's that I was doing look like this. See? Anyway. Yeah, this lady I worked with could draw a bowl of cereal, and it would, when she was doing it, it looked like she was just scribbling like a little kid. But when it was done, it looked like the most awesome bowl of cereal ever. And she could do it in like 10 minutes. It was for like this, like a foot wide, 2 feet wide bowl of cereal. It was amazing. Anyway, E, Now you got to be careful when you do E's and F's for these lines that come out. Like you can choose to make them all the same length. I usually don't. I usually stagger them a little bit. Maybe leave the little one of them longer than the other or one of them shorter than the others. But you just got to find a length that's right for you so it doesn't look awkward. And I found that if I draw the like column like this and then add these on, it always looks awkward to me. Like I don't like how that looks. I like to draw the whole E and then add the thickening. And that's my personal preference. You can make whatever choices you want to. And then with E here, you just make your E and then drop it down. Doing the one side's nice too. You just have to kind of get used to the interesting little thinness of the part that's not getting thickened. But I think it, especially if you do a lot of thickening on your cursive and with the serif type letters, you doing it this way kind of gives you a chance to mix it up and not have everything look like you're doing the same exact thing that's just mildly different. It's kind of cool to have some variety. So when I do F's, when I like strike through, I usually leave a little bit of extra room on the side so that it kind of looks even. You can always do that later too if you want to. And then G. Now there's a lot of different ways to do G. However you want to do G, just make your G how you want to make it and then do your drop down on the one side you've chosen to thicken. Now for the lowercase G, and I'm not even gonna go into the fancy squiggly one because I'm too tired for that. There's two ways that I've done it. One is where you bring it up around like that, like a usual kind of G, you know? And then I drop down here. And then because this curve right here is like in the same like zone, I would drop down there too. So you can do it like that. That's not how I did it on the worksheet. How I did it on the worksheet was a way where you kind of avoid that situation by making your G and then having it kind of be abbreviated and then just drop down here. But you can do it either way, whichever way you like. This way it looks kind of unfinished, but the whole font to me looks unfinished, so that kind of goes. But this is cute too. Your call, your planner. I say that a lot. I keep taking up a lot of space today. One day I'm gonna figure out a good filming situation, but not today. Okay. G, H. I'm not missing any letters today. H. Draw your H and then thicken one side. And then same here. Remember to make it a little extra poofy. And then thicken one side. So, since you've. I mean, I've been rambling a lot in this video, and I think it's because. No one. Okay, like I said, I was rambling. With the eye situation. I guess if it was going to be sans serif, I wouldn't have done these two serifs here. But I just don't like the eye by itself with no little things. It makes me think of an L. So, I just do that to differentiate. But you could do it like this for uppercase I. Just draw a little rectangle. You do that too. I just don't like it that much. Same with the lowercase I. I don't do as big of a serif, but I do kind of similar. And again, if that bugs you that you have the serif, you could just do it this way. I just can't physically bring myself to do it like that. For some reason, I don't like that. Anyway, J. Again, I did the same thing. There's your J. Now you can add the serif, which is what I usually do, even in this font style. I'm a rebel and I do what I want. And then with the J on the worksheet, I did it both ways. I did the unfinished way where you just sort of taper it off like that. Or you can do it the more finished way and do it like that.